Hello everyone. Today we are going to start with unit number 6, that is power electronics applications. This is a topic of power electronics subject of third year ENTC. In today's lecture we are going to see UPS, electronics blast, LED lamp with a driver circuit and fan regulator, and driver circuits of various motors. Myself, Professor Amit Kumar Mishra. I am having total 10 years of teaching experience and my domain expertise is of 10 years. So let's start with this. First of all, UPS. Power electronics can be used in a variety of applications. These are as follows: DC motor drives, AC motor, speed control, UPS and electronic blast. Special motor drives for stepper motors and brushless DC motors. UPS system not only supplies an uninterruptible power to these critical loads, but it takes care of following things as well. It regulates the load voltage when the main voltage fluctuates. It suppresses the line transient that otherwise would have been easily coupled to the load. It supplies a pure harmonic free signal to the load. Concept of UPS is going to get clear through this figure. First of all, types of UPS. There are two types of UPS, online UPS and offline UPS. In this figure, you can see like there is a rectifier. So what this rectifier will do, it is going to convert this AC voltage into pulsating DC. Then that DC is going to store in these batteries. Simultaneously, this DC is directly fed to the inverter or through this battery, and this inverter will convert this DC into AC. Now, there are two switches. One is main static switch, which is upper one, and UPS static switch, which is lower one. So if lower switch is on, so this AC, which has been produced by the inverter, is going to fed to the load. And if this is on, means UPS static switch is on, then main static switch will be off. In case UPS static switch is off, then main static switch will be on. And in that case, directly the line supply is going to fed to the load. Based on that only, there are two types of UPS, as I said, online UPS and offline UPS. Now, in online UPS, what happens is, this lower switch, that is UPS static switch, is mainly on and main static switch is mainly off. So what happened is, due to as this is on, so this AC supply is going to fed to the rectifier. This rectifier converts that into DC. This DC is going to store in the battery as well as it is going to pass through the inverter. So this DCs get converted into AC. And as this is closed, in case of online UPS, so it is going to fed to the load. In case of offline UPS, this switch, UPS static switch, is off and main static switch is on. So mostly this line supply directly fed to the load through this switch. Simultaneously, this line supply is fed to the rectifier, so it convert that AC into DC, and DC is getting stored to the batteries. If there is any power failure takes place or there is problem in line supply, in that case, in offline UPS, this switch, which is main static switch, will get off and UPS static switch will get on. And then the power or DC which is stored in the battery is fed to the inverter. Inverter will convert that DC into AC, and then that AC is going to fed to the load. Now, how to remember through this figure the difference between online and offline UPS? It's simple. When we are talking about UPS, that means if power conversion taking place in this way and then it is fed to the load, that means it is going through the UPS. So in UPS or in online UPS, power conversion must take place through this. So this lower switch, that is UPS static switch, is on mainly, whereas main static switch is off. And in offline UPS means it is not going through this UPS mainly. Most of the time it is going off the UPS. means of the UPS means what? It is directly the line is feeding to the load. So that is only possible when our main static switch is on. And once main static switch is on, in that case, UPS static switch will be off. So that is your offline UPS. Let's see the specification of online UPS. First is power rating. So online UPS comes with 1 kVA, 2 kVA, 5 kVA power rating. Output voltage in online UPS is 230 volt with a difference of plus minus 5%. Output frequency 50 hertz with variation of plus minus 2 hertz. Input voltage 190 to 260 volt. Nature of output voltage waveform, it's sinusoidal. Power factor, it's greater than 0.8. Basically, ideal power factor is of 1, but we never get 1 because it's an ideal one, but closer to 1 is also good, and power factor of 0.8 is good. Backup time, 30 minutes to 4 hours. Total harmonic distortion, THD, is less than 5%. That is good. Efficiency is greater than 85%. And protection circuits which are used are over voltage protection circuit and over current protection circuit. Next topic is electronics blast. Electronic blast is basically a power converter which uses a very high frequency inverter which normally operates at a frequency which is of the order of 40 kilohertz. This will eliminate the need of choke and improve the efficiency. This is the circuit diagram of electronic blast. We have a line input voltage that is passed through this filter. So this filter will remove any ripple in that and get to the rectifier section. This rectifier will convert this AC into DC. Again, that DC will be a pulsating DC. So there are some ripples or noise. So that will be removed with the help of this part. And then through this half bridge resonant output, it is going to fed to the lamp or tube light. And everything happens in a controlled manner with the help of this control circuit. Basically, electronic blast is having very high efficiency, so it is used for emergency power supply. The only disadvantage of electronic blast is low power factor. Next topic is LED lamp with driver circuit. This is the circuit diagram for LED driver circuit. This is the LED that we need to drive. So this is the circuit diagram for that. With the help of this circuit, we are going to drive this LED. Here we are giving the main supply 240 volts, or we can say it's 230 volt. This capacitor is used that will drive the low current from here. This AC is fed to the rectifier section. So this rectifier section will convert this AC into pulsating DC. This capacitor is going to act like a filter, which is going to remove the pulsating part in the DC. Voltage across this Zener diode will be lower. And before feeding it to the LED, again it is passed through the capacitive filter. And once it is passed through the capacitive filter, after that it is fed to the LED, and LED will get on or it will get drive. Advantage of this driver circuit is LED is directly drive through the 230 AC supply. So there is no need of any transformer. Hence the size of the circuit is small and it will be quite cheaper also. The only disadvantage is as directly the AC supply is connected to the LED, so it is quite dangerous. Application of this LED driver circuit is it is used for domestic lighting system. Next topic is fan regulator using triac. This is the circuit diagram of fan regulator using triac. This is a triac. Triac means back-to-back connection of SCR. This is the gate terminal of triac. This is diac. Diac means back-to-back connection of SCR but without gate. This is our load, or we can say fan. We are giving the AC input from this side. Now this AC will consist of positive half cycle and negative half cycle. Now during positive half cycle, this will be positive and this will be negative. So the current will start flowing through R1 to R2 and it will go to C1. So the capacitor will start charging. once the voltage across capacitor become equal to breakover voltage of diac, this diac will get on and it will allow the flow of current to the triac, gate of the triac. So the triac will get triggered and it will get on. So this will become short, or we can say this becomes short. So the current will start flowing through this loop and we will get the output across load or fan will start moving. Let's see what happened during the negative half cycle of the AC. During negative half cycle of the AC, this is negative, this is positive. So current will start flowing through in this manner. What will happen is, this time the voltage store over here or voltage appear across the capacitor will be negative, but this is diac. Diac is bidirectional device, so it will get on even though negative supply will appear across it. Therefore, diac will get on once the voltage across the capacitor is equal to or greater than breakover voltage of the diac. So that it will pass the current to the gate of the triac. Triac will get triggered and hence it will get on. Again, it will be short, or we can say this will be short. Current will flow through this circuit in this manner or in this manner, and we are going to get the output across the load or fan will start moving. So it will keep on moving during positive as well as during negative half cycle of the AC. So this is fan regulator using triac. Next is single phase separately excited DC motor drive. Now, what is separately excited DC drive? So here you can see this is the field winding of the motor. This is armature winding of the motor. This field winding and armature windings are not directly connected, but we are giving the supply to the field winding, and due to mutual inductance, armature winding is getting the supply and hence it is getting excited. So this is separately excited DC motor. Let's see few equations related with this. First of all, we will see few terms, like P denotes number of poles of the machine, phi denotes flux per mole in Weber, Z denotes total number of armature conductors, N is speed of armature in revolution per minute, RPM, and A is number of parallel paths in the armature winding. Flux cut by one conductor in one revolution is D phi, that is equal to P phi. Number of revolution per second, speed in RPS is N by 60. Time for one revolution is dt, that is equal to 60 by n seconds. And from equation 1, EMF generated per conductor is d phi by dt, that is p phi n upon 60. Therefore, EMF generated will be p phi nz upon 60a. We have speed of the motor is directly proportional to V minus IARA, and it is inversely proportional to phi. If we neglect this term for a while, we can also say that N is directly proportional to V and inversely proportional to phi, or N depends on V by phi. So, factor affecting speed of DC motor are: speed is inversely proportional to flux, speed is directly proportional to armature voltage, and speed is directly proportional to applied voltage. So by varying one of these parameters, it is possible to change the speed of a DC motor. Stepper motor driver. This is open loop control of stepper motor. The input controller sends a train of pulse or spikes to the logic sequencer, which converts them into rectangular pulses that are to be applied to the four phase windings of the motor. Motor which is shown above is stepper motor, which is a four phase motor. Rectangular waveforms applied to these phase are in sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, and one phase is excited at a time. That means the rectangular pulse is applied only to one phase at a time. Motor driver is a power circuit which supplies the required amount of current to the phase windings of the motor. With these energizing sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, the motor rotates in counterclockwise direction. If the sequence is reversed, then it will rotate in the clockwise direction. Next is BLDC motor driver. This is the circuit diagram of BLDC, bipolar full wave BLDC drive. The synchronous motor, when used in self-controlled mode of operation, is known as brushless DC motor. The power transistor in the voltage-fed inverter that drives the BLDC motor are controlled by pulses generated by the rotor position sensors. The permanent magnet synchronous motor operating in the self-controlled mode is known as brushless DC motor. Even the speed torque characteristic is similar to that of DC motor. In figure, you can see that from there you can understand the transistors in the inverter circuits are switched in pairs. At a time, two transistors will conduct one each from the upper and lower three transistors in the inverter. The driver circuits are basically the current drivers for the power transistors. As the lower three transistor receives the PWM signal and are turned on and off more than once during their conduction period, they are being switched at higher frequency. Therefore, sometimes the lower transistors are replaced by MOSFET. In that case, the lower three drivers should be totem pole drivers. The control circuit for BLDC motors is available in the IC form and has the following features: under voltage lockout, error amplifier for closed loop servo applications, cycle by cycle current limiting, internal thermal shutdown, fault detection and shutdown. Next is three phase induction motor drive. Three phase induction motors are most common and frequently encountered machines in industry. There are three types of speed control of three-phase induction motors. First is varying supply voltage and supply frequency. Second is supply voltage, varying supply voltage. And third is varying rotor resistance. We are going to see varying supply voltage and supply frequency, how to control the speed by varying supply voltage and supply frequency for three-phase induction motor. What is this varying voltage and varying frequency? Basically, we have to keep V by F ratio, voltage by frequency ratio, constant. Now, what happens in case of motor is N, that is the speed of the motor, is equal to NS into 1 minus S, where NS is synchronous speed and S is the slack. Now, what happens is NS, which is synchronous speed, is equal to 120 F1 upon P. So, speed of motor, that is N is equal to NS into 1 minus S. So speed of motor depends on synchronous speed. Synchronous speed depends on the frequency. Means if I'm changing frequency, synchronous speed get change. Synchronous speed get change means what? Speed of the motor, that is N get change. But here is one factor, that is of voltage. If we are changing F and keeping V constant, then there is some adverse effect on the air gap flux. It is only because air gap flux is directly proportional to V by F. That means if you are changing F, we can't keep V constant. Otherwise, core saturation will occur. Therefore, if we are reducing frequency, we have to increase voltage and vice versa, so that ratio V by F remains constant. So that can be achieved with the help of this circuit. Means we have to vary V as well as we have to vary F, so that the ratio V by F remains constant. So flux, there will be no adverse effect on the air gap flux and core saturation won't occur. So let's see this block diagram because of which we are getting V by F constant. So it consists of a converter that will convert this AC into DC. This input will be three phase constant voltage, constant frequency supply that will be fed to this AC to DC converter. So that get converted into DC. Now this DC is passed to the DC filter. So some ripples are there that will get removed. And later on it is going to get passed to the inverter section. So this inverter section will convert this DC into AC of variable frequency and variable voltage. So as the output is variable frequency and variable voltage, V by F is going to remain constant. So therefore, this is called as variable voltage, variable frequency, V by F control of induction motor. In this lesson, we have learned UPS, uninterruptible power supply, electronics blast, LED lamp and fan regulator, and driver circuit of various motors. Thank you.